Okay, so after the referencing style is done, now the important aspect which needs to be taken care of is to provide the final title and abstract. Abstract should be written at the end because it has to be a kind of a selling point. You know, abstract is one of the most important pieces in the research paper. The reason is very, very clear because most of the journals publish the articles in a paid form. It's not open access or gold access. So anybody who would like to purchase the research article would be doing that specifically on the basis of the abstract, and therefore it has to be understood here that the abstract should be a clear summarization of the entire text. The second thing, which is again very, very important, is the title of the article. As we have discussed previously, that the title has to be thought of beforehand. Okay, but now is the time when you can make the final changes in the title of the article. You will have to assess whether the title is in sync with the contents of the article, and therefore this is a crucial time when both the things need to be drafted in the best possible manner. Also, it is advisable that you can ask certain questions to yourself as well as your co-authors, as well as you can ask other people, scholars in that field of study, to review your abstract and title if they do not have time to review the entire article. It will help you in understanding what mistakes you are doing in writing the title and the abstract. So sending that abstract and title to some 5 or 6 experts in that area is a commonly recommended thing which should be done. The next thing is the journal in which you are submitting. You have to reread whatever instructions you have been given. As I have previously mentioned, that in the earlier stages of your work, you should have chosen upon the journal and worked your article according to what the journal is prescribing. So it is important now at this stage also to reread the journal's instructions. This is a common mistake which we do. We do not read the instructions provided by the journal and make mistakes in submitting the article. I have also seen articles getting rejected because it does not meet the journal's instructions, and the editor's clear-cut instruction say when they are rejecting the article that if an author is not serious enough to look into the prospects of the journal and the instructions given, how can we expect the author to, you know, work around other things in the revision process or any other process which comes out later on? So it is also a way to find out how serious a writer, an author is while submitting an article to a given journal. So it's important that we read the instructions well, and in the same stead also provide written notes to the editor. Because how do we actually write the notes to the editor? We can do it through the cover letter. Most of you must be knowing about it. If you have submitted articles to good peer reviewed journals, that you'll have to submit a cover letter. Now, what does this cover letter talk about? This cover letter talks about not what you have actually written in your abstract or whatever you have found out exactly as in your research article, because those things are already there. So any other information which should be known to the editor should be written in the cover letter. For example, how you have derived the data, is the data openly accessed, is accessible, have you put it in a data repository, any conflict of interest with the funding authorities, who is the funding authority, if at all there is any funding authority. And if there are some exceptions to what generally people talk about, so those things need to be taken care of and should be put in the view of the journal editor. Also, if some of the previous articles have already been published, keeping the same data set, you know, the same data, maybe it's a large study where you have collected wholesome data, and that you have divided or sliced into different segments, and then you are publishing it. So those information, like this data has already been used for publishing some papers and such things, such information which can be categorized as salami tactics or maybe text recycling or data manipulation. So such things, if the author already knows about it, should be presented in the cover letter, which is written specifically to the editor. Most of the journals ask for this cover letter, but there are journals also who they do not ask for cover letters. In such situations, they clearly make this known to the authors that they do not want any cover letter. However, if there are any exceptions, then definitely a note to the editor can be brought forward. So these are the things which are important. Then you can prepare the final illustrations, tables, graph. You have to cross check if every table is being cited in the text, every figure is being cited in the text or not, because if you do not do it properly, chances are that you will be asked to resubmit your document again. So in this stage you should look for each aspects closely. Then the next thing is get feedback on manuscript and revise accordingly. Now, getting feedback on manuscript is important. We generally skip this important aspect. Why? Because we do not have, say, much time. We have already spent a lot of time in writing the article, but this is again a very important step. Reason is that we can judge our paper on the prism of our own intellect. We are not able to actually bring into our own mind some of the mistakes which are very evident, but we may overlook it. Even I'm talking about, if all the co-authors also proofread the article well, they may skip some of the points because it can be myopic in that sense. So it's better to send out the manuscript to good friends who are scholars and are working in the same domain area, so that they can give final suggestions on improving the manuscript. And if some important aspects, though very brief and small, may be left out, could be incorporated in the text accordingly. And then, yeah, definitely taking, if you feel that those feedback can be taken up and it will help the paper to be improved, then definitely you should go for revising it accordingly. Then you submit the manuscript according to the guidelines which is provided in the journal, and then submit it. If you're lucky enough, your paper will not be desk rejected. If you have gone through all the editorials which the journal brings out and specifies what important things should be done and should not be done about an article, if you have followed all the guidelines, read the scope, aim of the journal, and if your article actually matches that, plus if the editor feels that this article can be a well-cited one once it gets published and it actually makes any kind of significant contribution, then the editor sends it for reviews. You know, generally the process nowadays with good journals is that they are accepting very less papers and for even review. So desk rejection rates are quite high, 80%, 90% of the papers. The reason can be many, but the most important reason with the journal's side because of desk rejecting an article is when they feel that the authors are non-serious about their papers. They have just submitted the article in order to get a viewpoint. This also happens. So if the articles are in conjunction and in line with what the journal looks for, mostly the chances are that the article will move through the desk rejection stage. It will not be desk rejected in the first go. And again, then you're lucky enough, you'll get the reviews. It may take a lot of time depending on what journal time span is. Most of the journals today are looking for a quick review. However, it depends on the time and availability of the reviewers, and no journal can actually give you a timeline as to when will the reviews come out. So it's a painstakingly it takes a long time, and patience is generally appreciated from the authors, that they give the ample time to the reviewers and the journal editor so that they can bring out a good review. So and then once the review is with you, then each of the aspects, you know, pointed out, you may not agree to all the aspects which the reviewers have pointed out, but if they have asked you to revise the paper, nothing better than this, because actually the paper has been found out to be of scientific value and evidence to the people. So it is important then for you to take every aspect of the review in consideration and revise it point wise. If you have certain observations to make about the review, you can write that to the editor and ask for further clarification if you really want to get into it. Other than that, it's better to have the article reviewed according to the reviewer's suggestions. So this is how you can write down the whole article and submit and have a final laugh when you're actually getting your article published. It's time for you to enjoy. So this is the process of writing a good research article.